friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. And as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Look at me. I'm limited. And just look at you. You can do all I couldn't do, Glinda. So now it's up to you. People come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a sea dropped by a sky bird in a distant stand to word. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore.
stars here. If all the and if all the good and I am thinking, praising out the empty king. Where are these dazzling brightness, these gods with a pain, clad in robes of purest whiteness? By time's rude man, whence came all this glorious band? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Well, welcome to your graduation mass. It's been a funny sort of year, but I'm so very happy that we can celebrate this mass together. We are all very, very proud of you. I know your parents share that emotion with me. And very coincidentally, or not so coincidentally, I'm not a believer in coincidences, this day that we picked for your graduation a long time ago, it's also the day on which we commemorate the Mexican martyrs, those men, women, and children who gave their lives in the last century in defense of the Catholic faith, in defense of their church, during what is known as the Cristero War. So we will remember them also in our prayers this evening. And I offer these sacred mysteries for your intentions. My brothers and sisters, so that we may celebrate together worthily, let us first call to mind our sins, asking God for pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who made the priest Saint Christopher Magajanus and his companions faithful to Christ the King, even to the point of martyrdom, grant us, through their intercession, that persevering in confession of the true faith, we may always hold fast to the commandments of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of Apostles. Paul left Athens and went to Corinth. There he met a Jew named Aquila, a native of Pontus, who had recently come from Italy with his wife Priscilla, because Claudius had ordered all the Jews to leave Rome. He went to visit them, and because he practiced the same trade, stayed with them and worked for they were tent makers by trade. Every Sabbath he entered into discussions in the synagogue, attempting to convince both Jews and Greeks. When Silas and Timothy came down from Macedonia, Paul began to occupy himself totally with preaching the word, testifying to the Jews in the Christ with Jesus. When they opposed him and revealed him, he shook out his garments and said to them, "Your blood be on your heads. I'm clear of responsibility. From now on, I will go to the Gentiles." So he left there and went to a house belonging to a man named Titus, Justus, a worshiper of God. His house was next to a synagogue. Crispus, the synagogue official, came to believe in the Lord, along with his entire household, and many of the Corinthians who heard believed it and were baptized. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "A little while, and you will no longer see me. And again, a little while later, and you will see me. So some of his disciples said to one another, what does this mean that he is saying to us, a little while and you will not see me, and again, a little while and you will see me, and because I am going to the Father. So they said, what is this little while of which he speaks? What do we know what he means? Jesus knew that they wanted to ask him, so he said to them, are you discussing with one another what I said? A little while, and you will not see me, and again, a little while, and you will see me? Amen, amen, I say to you, you will weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You will grieve, but your grief will welcome joy. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Inspiration. Inspiration is the theme of tonight, really. Inspiration, to be inspired, in its now modern English word, means to have a great idea, to somebody to give you a great idea, or to trigger you into a great deed or great action. In its old English, it literally meant to breathe in, to inspire, and that inspiration was connected to the work of the Holy Spirit. To be inspired was to be filled with the Holy Spirit, empowered for the mission of evangelization, to go out and tell the world the good news about Jesus Christ. Now, I'm not expecting in the next 9 days or anywhere in the immediate future that tongues of flame are going to come down on your heads, or that a great rushing wind is going to come and blow you off your feet, although with the thunder that's working out there, maybe that will happen. But to be inspired by the Holy Spirit, means to be open to the working of the Holy Spirit. You are graduating from St. Luke. During your time here, whether it's just been 1 year this year, whether it's been the whole of your school career here, or whether it's just been in between that, your teachers, our youth minister, your priests, we have tried to inspire you with the Holy Spirit. That's what some of those goals that we've been chanting every morning, seek, persist, excel, love, serve. These are all attributes of being open to the work of the Spirit in our lives. Your mission, as you leave St. Luke and as you mature into teenager, into adulthood, is to discover the inspiration of the Holy Spirit in your lives. What is the Holy Spirit calling me to do? How am I meant to spend my life? One of the great popes of the church, Pope St. John Paul II, said, the great meaning or purpose of life is to discover what it's all about. We hope we've put you on the road to that journey of discovery. To be a faithful follower of Jesus, to discover his purpose in your life, brings with it great joy. I don't often do this, but I'm going to cite my personal story a little bit for you. Because I went through school and high school and even went into college not knowing what I should do. I accidentally became a lawyer, a trial attorney, because nobody in my family was a lawyer, and I thought, well, you can earn lots of money being a lawyer. I don't know if that's true anymore. And I became a lawyer, and it seemed to work. But I wasn't inspired. I was not really listening. One day, I read a book. And that's how the Holy Spirit can speak to you. He can speak to you in books, in movies, in the words of friends or teachers or parents. Be open to his inspiration. The book I read was called The Power and the Glory. It's written by an Englishman called Graham Greene, who was a Catholic writer. Well, this was not a book all about being a good soldier of Christ. Well, it was, but very subtly. That book, The Power and the Glory, told the story of a priest in Mexico in the 1920s. He wasn't a very good priest. He'd actually had an affair and had a child. He liked his drink too much. But the call came in the midst of persecution when he saw his fellow priests being arrested and killed. And he knew somebody had to go out there and baptize children and marry couples and bury the dead. And that's what he did in his own not perfect way. An inspiration. We can be inspired by the example of that fictional priest, but so many like him who we commemorate today, who did give their lives for the faith and the church. They were inspired. So be open to inspiration. I'm going to read you some words of John Paul II. These are some words he gave to another set of young people when he met them on one of the World Youth Days. It's in following Jesus that youth, young people, display all the richness of its potentiality and acquires its full meaning. You have potential and meaning ahead of you. It is in following Jesus that the young discover the sense of a life lived as a gift of self and experience the beauty and truth of growing in love. It is in following Jesus that they feel themselves called to communion with him as living members of a single body, which is the church. It is in following Jesus that it will be possible for them to understand the personal call to love in marriage, in the consecrated life, in the ordained ministry, in the mission to the people of God. Discover your mission. Be inspired. Live lives of faith, hope, and love. And you will be a credit not just to you, your parents, your church, your school. You will be a credit to the Holy Spirit who inspires you. So let us stand so that we can offer our prayers. Jesus inspires us with his peace, his love, and his obedience to the Father. In that same inspiration, let us now bring before him our petitions.
For all the members of the church, that we may be inspired by the presence of Christ in our midst, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us here, that we may never be frightened to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our graduates, that we will recognize the inspiration of Christ in our lives and seek to serve him in all that we do, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our parents and guardians, we give thanks for their continuing inspiration and love in our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our teachers and all who have sought to guide, instruct, and counsel us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone before us in faith, that they will find the fullness of joy in God's presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, you have given us new birth as your sons and daughters, so that we may have a sure and certain hope of our own resurrection. Help us so to live as to make this truth known throughout the world, through Christ our Lord. Please be seated whilst we prepare the altar for the Eucharist. Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name. name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim the Lord and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Gerald our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Christopher Magellanus, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in hard days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And let us offer one other sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And as I receive communion, I invite you to make an act of spiritual communion.
I compare a kingdom on you, just as my Father has conferred one on me.
let us pray.
Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food. Through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Boys, you can replace your caps. And Mrs. Backus, over to you. We're going to get rolling with the graduation ceremony.
To celebrate the class of 2020 as they continue on their path to college in heaven. I can tell you it's been a lonely couple of months on campus, so I've missed you. I've recently been reminded that I was this class's, when they were in sixth grade, their math and science teacher, and I have very vivid memories of that time. And from my perspective as a teacher, there are several things that really stand out. The first is that there was a group of girls who were very intense and driven. But for the life of me, I could not get their names straight. Angel was April, Naima was Jennifer, Mia was Kiona. It was a real mess. The second thing that stands out is that there were a group of students, and you know who you are, who never really stopped talking in class. There was always this hum around them. It was extremely frustrating because I would socially distance them, but they still talked. And then finally, the third thing that stands out in my mind, and this is an odd one, is that no one seemed to be able to tie their shoes. Every time they came into my class, and I saw them twice a day, their shoes would be untied, and I'd have to say, why are your shoes untied? Tie your shoes, you're gonna trip. It was unending, it was exhausting. So I started thinking about them from my principal's perspective, and this is what I see now, 3 years later, the class of 2020, let me think. There's still a group of intense girls that I cannot remember their names, and I muddle them continue. And I can very say I'm sorry about that. The talkers are still talking, and 9 times out of 10, the first words out of my mouth when they come into my office is, why are your shoes untied? Tie your shoes, you're gonna trip. So not a lot has changed over the last 3 years, which is good when I start thinking about this kind of Trump world we've been living in. But class, scholars, to be honest, I've been worried about you. You struggle so to tie your shoes, and I kept thinking to myself, how are they going to make it in high school? But upon further reflection, and looking at you all here today, I know my fears were absolutely unfounded. As a St. Luke graduate, you have something your public school counterparts do not have. You have an educational foundation rooted in God and the gospel. During your time here at St. Luke, Father Andrew's leadership, and with your teacher's guidance, you have developed a relationship with God. It is not by accident that in the last 10 weeks, you have been able to successfully make it through the pandemic, conquer e-learning, and survive basically 2 months of lockdown with your parents as teenagers. That's no easy task. You're sitting here tonight because of your relationship with God, because of your faith. My advice, my one piece of advice to you tonight, is to continue to grow your faith. Keep praying every day. Live those core values. Go to Mass on Sunday and celebrate the Eucharist. Because if you do, you will become the best possible version of yourself, the version that God created you to be. And that is what success looks like when you are in high school. So, congratulations to you all. I love you all. I look forward to you coming back with your shoes tied and telling me all the wonderful things that you are continuing to do on that path to college in heaven. Thank you. Now I get to ask Ms. Ryan to come up here. We are going to start probably the award section. So Ms. Ryan's going to come up, announce the names, and Father Andrew and I will be passing the awards out. I'm going to ask you students two things. I'm going to ask you not to shake Father Andrew's hand. Normally we would. He's just going to hand you your awards and diploma when it's time. That's right. And the other is that when you, after you receive it, could you just turn? We we have a photographer who's going to snap a picture of you with your awards and diplomas. Okay? Thank you. Oh, and I need a couple boys. You two, Nickinson and Sean Lee. Can you help me move the table, please?
Good evening, everybody. I've missed all of you this past 2 months, so I'm so glad I was able to come and see you this evening. Tonight, we are honoring and celebrating those students who are examples of our core values: seek, persist, excel, love, and serve. Students will be recognized for academic excellence in individual classes and service. Students, when your name is called, we will list the awards you are receiving. Please come forward and accept your award from Father Andrew. Kayla Presendue, Academic Excellence in Media. Julian Dorsey, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll. Thomas Phoebus, Academic Excellence, Physical Education. Michelle Shamu, Service Award, Altar Serving. Sophia Hanna, Service Award, Altar Serving. Jennifer Fiera, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll and Service Award, Altar Serving. Lindsay Elizalde, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Service Award, Altar Serving. Frankie Bernard, Service Awards, Altar Serving and Afternoon Announcements. Celine LaPlante, Academic Achievement National Latin Exam and Academic Excellence Religion. Carlos Rendon, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Service Awards, Video Support, and Flag Master. Diego Henkel, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Service Awards, Video Support, and Altar Serving. Julia Flores, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Service Awards, Morning Announcements, and Altar Serving. Naima Bien-Ami, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Academic Excellence in Physical Education, and Service Award, Morning Announcements. Mia Shaw, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Academic Excellence in Social Studies, Academic Achievement National Latin Exam, Service Award, Afternoon Announcements. Camilla Espeo, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Academic Excellence in Art, Service Award, Morning Announcements. April Cohen, Salatorian, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Perfect Attendance, Academic Excellence in Spanish, Service Award, Altar Serving, and Morning Announcements. And Miguel Corridor, Valedictorian, Fourth Quarter Honor Roll, Academic Excellence in Math, Academic Excellence in Science, Academic Excellence in Language Arts, Academic Outstanding Achievement, National Latin Exam, and Service Awards, Altar Serving, and Flag Master. And for our fourth quarter honor roll. The last student to be called up will be receiving two awards. The first is for academic excellence in STEM. The second award is for the Spartan Spirit Award. The Spartan Spirit Award is given to a student who exemplifies a St. Luke student, a student who lives the core values and models a Christian spirit. This year's recipient is always the first to volunteer. They seek new learning opportunities, and above all, they are kind, loving, and welcoming to all. The Class of 2020 Spartan Spirit Award goes to Kiona Presendu.
Father, I'm going to have to sit down for just a second because we are going to have, I'd like Miguel and April to come up here, our valedictorian and salutatorian. Please come forward. It is with great pleasure that I invite April Cohen, to our salutatorian for the class of 2020. To say a few words.
Hi everyone. I would like to thank everyone who's helped me and supported me. And first, I'd like to thank my family who's given me absolutely everything that I need to be the best that I can. I want to thank my friends who I can't live without and truly mean the entire world to me. And lastly, I want to thank Father Andrew and everyone at St. Luke for making this possible. Attending St. Luke was a life-changing experience. At this school, I have met so many great people that I couldn't imagine my life without. I have made my closest friends here, and I consider them my family. St. Luke is my family, actually. Not only just my friends, but the teachers here, especially Coach, who has always done so much. I have a lot of respect for him, and I'm very grateful for him and everything that he's taught me. Going to St. Luke also changed the way I see my life. It taught me many things, and I'm not only talking about academics. It showed me how much even a small community can come together and do a lot, and how there's the same amount of love, if anything more. It taught me how Catholicism isn't just a faith that we practice, but a way of life. Before I came to St. Luke, my faith wasn't a big part of my life. Practicing my faith daily took some getting used to. However, I saw how much of an impact it made in my life. I saw everyone and everything differently. I'm not perfect, nobody is, but it helped me to try my hardest to be the closest to perfect that I can be, not only just for myself, but for God and for all the things and opportunities that He's given me. So, my class isn't the best class, but like, we're pretty cool, so it's okay. We have some people that are really smart that I know will make a big difference, and there are some people that have dedicated their lives to sports, and I can be the first to tell you that I wouldn't be surprised to see some of you guys playing professionally all over TV in a few years. And there are some that just brighten up the room the second they walk in and just have the ability to make you smile and feel good. If I could give one piece of advice to everyone of you guys here is that nothing you want to accomplish is impossible. When we all try our hardest as a class and come together for something we really want, we do it, and we do it at the best of our abilities. What makes any of our dreams any different? Everyone sitting in this church has the power to do big things and change the world for the greater good. Whether anyone here will remember me in a year or two or more, I'll never forget you guys. For the reason, you guys are the reason that I am who I am today, and I couldn't be more grateful. Thank you again, and I love every single one of you.
April, I ask that Miguel Corridor please come, or valedictorian, for the class of 2020.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. When I learned that I was going to give a speech as a valedictorian, my first thought was, Why did I have to guess all the right answers on those Latin tests? If I had failed at least some of them, I would just be sitting over there not worrying about giving a speech. But here I am. Anyways, I want to start by giving thanks first to God for all his blessings, to Father Andrew, to our principal Ms. Bacchus, to all the teachers for their commitment to our education, both academic and spiritual, and for your effort to make this graduation ceremony possible. I want to thank my family, my grandparents and uncle, for their unconditional love and support. Dad, thank you for being a constant and calming presence in my life. Mom, thank you for believing in me and encouraging me to do my best. You know, whenever I got a B, she knew I could do better and encouraged me to try harder. Quite badly sometimes. Love you, Mom. My mom told me that before I was born, some cars here at St. Luke had stickers that said, "Everybody is somebody at St. Luke Catholic School." She loved that slogan and hoped that when she had children, they would attend St. Luke. So she got her wish, and for the past 9 years, I've been a student at this small but wonderful school. We've been through a lot of changes, but we have embraced those changes and thrived. We've seen wonderful teachers leave and new amazing teachers join. Some friends have left, and even though we still miss them, we have welcomed new friends. And as with everything in life, we've had our ups and downs. But in my experience, especially this past year, thanks to the Lion's compassionate and caring guidance of Father Andrew, Ms. Bacchus, and all the teachers and staff, I can honestly say that everybody is somebody here at St. Luke School. Today, as we close this chapter in our lives and open a new one, sometimes with apprehension for the unknown, sometimes with great hope for a bright future ahead, my wish for all of us is that wherever we go, whatever path we choose, we may show what we learned here at St. Luke and always seek, persist, excel, love, and serve. Thank you.
Okay, it's time for the diplomas. Ms. Ryan will be announcing your name, and Father Andrew and I will be handing them out. Students, when we go ahead and stand up, please. You're on the ends. Students, stand up. Thank you.
Willermine Adolphe.
Frankie Bernard.
We've lost the photographer. Well done. Where's the photographer? Okay. Keep going.
Naima Bien Ami. Michelle Shamu. April Cohen. Miguel Corridor. Jeremy Diaz, Julian Dorsey, Lindsay Elizalde, Camilla Espejo, Jennifer Fiera, Julia Flores, Sophia Hanna, Connor Hawkins, Diego Hankel, Celine LaPlante, Angelie Moss, Maria Morales, Kayla Presendum, Kiona Presendu, Thomas Priebus, Carlos Rendon, Christian Rossi, Mia Shaw,
Department of Education and the Florida Catholic Conference, you have successfully completed all required courses. I do declare you graduated from St. Luke School, a Notre Dame ACE Academy. Graduates, please turn your tassel from right to left. I present to you the class of 2020. Congratulations.
Watching from home. Thank you very much. Let's all stand for the blessing. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads for God's blessing. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, fill your hearts with the knowledge and love of his Son, Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. And as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Look at me. I'm limited. And just look at you. You can do all I couldn't do. Glinda. So now it's up to you. Something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? I knew you. I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a sea dropped by a sky bird in sent a word. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore.
Pass when a child is born.